Hello and welcome. My name is Shailesh Kumar and you are watching National Defense. Maratha Light Infantry is celebrating 250 glorious years of its raising. I am going to tell you 6 great stories of Maratha Light Infantry soldiers and officers that will certainly get you goosebumps. First story is of Colonel Saurabh Singh Shekhawat, who in 2008 led an operation in Loktak Lake in Manipur, killing 8 terrorists without any collateral damage. That operation was more of a challenge as there was no ground for cover.
There was a terrorist group which was creating a lot of mayhem. They were, you know, ambushing police, they were ambushing army columns, they attacked when the parliament, the state parliament was in session. They were extorting money, they were abducting children for recruitment. So such activities they were doing. And they had their camp in a very in a lake on floating island where no one could reach. So we got the information and we developed a source and we pinpointed the target. But the target was on a floating island and no one could reach there. So we learned to row the boats which were being rowed by, used by locals. They were very small, you know, narrow canoes. So that was a very technical and very difficult part, because if you don't know how to row the boat, you will fall in the water. And then the another peculiarity was that there was no ground to fight. There was no cover. When you fight, the siklai, the training is that you see the enemy, fire and take cover. Take cover. But there was no cover there. You were in open. So this was the situation which I had put across in front of my boys, and I said that our surprise, our cover is our surprise. You lose surprise, you will be fired upon, and you are in the open, you are standing in the boat on the platforms, shoulder to shoulder, there is not even gap between the soldiers. So if you lose surprise, we are going to, you know, bite, we are going to suffer casualties. So, but none of the soldier, you know, flinched. And everyone said that we will maintain surprise and we will take this target out. And finally we prepared, we did a lot of rehearsals, for 45 days we prepared, and finally when the go ahead was given, we went and we raided the target, and in very small time, 4-5 minutes, the whole operation was over. And the best part of this operation was that there was no collateral damage. Number one, no civilian suffered any injury, there was no damage to any property of any in the civilians living around, and none of us lost a limb or life. So that was the most satisfying part for me as a commander, as a leader, that I brought all my numbers back. In Indian Army, life is very different, very challenging, and once you join Indian Army, you are in a different environment. The environment which we see generally, the problems which are plaguing the country, you know, there are divides, there is casteism, there is religion, you know, all these things are not there in army. You live in a very pluralistic secular society and you act like a unit. So when I was I keep saying this, when I was commissioned and when I joined special forces, I was asked by one of my NCO that what is your religion, what is your caste. I said I am Hindu Rajput. So he said, bloody chap, take a dip in that dirty water. So I went and I took a dip, then I realized that there's something wrong I have said. So again he asked. So then I said, sir, my religion is SF and my caste is SF. Now you know. So he then told me that, you see, you are an officer, and so your religion is the religion which is the religion of your boys. So if your boy is a Hindu, you are a Hindu. If your boy is a Sikh, you are a Sikh. If your boy is a Christian, you are a Christian. If boy is a Muslim, you are a Muslim. So as an officer, you are everything. So when we have this kind of template, and if you apply this template in the country, I think most of the problem will be solved.
Oh, that's great, in fact.
Yeah, and all the religions are there, all the classes and clans are together, and still they are one unit. And you see the performance of Indian Army. Whenever the chips are down, you call Indian Army, and Indian Army performs. So that is the strength.
Captain Sachin Bali had not signed up with Indian Army for desk job. He wanted to be with the soldiers on front line, and once he realized him being battle casualty won't allow him back in the field, he activated his career plan B. What was his career plan B? Watch for yourself.
I was posted in Siachen Glacier in 2002 and I went up the glacier when in extreme cold. That was the winters, November, starting November. Temperature in during that duration varies from minus 50 to minus 60 degrees centigrade. In March 2003, one of my posts came under avalanche. This was a middle post. And we had few soldiers who were still trapped under the snow and some were out in the open with minimum clothing. That's when I launched a rescue operations to evacuate them and get them out of the snow. On a usual clear day, it would have taken me not more than an hour to reach that place, but it had been snowing for the last 3 weeks before that and there was a lot of soft snow on the way. By the time we could reach that, complete the operation and come back, it took us almost 12 hours. And in such extreme temperature, you cannot stay out for more than 2 hours because your body starts freezing, your limbs start freezing, your jaw starts freezing, and body's already operating at 30% of oxygen than it actually requires. Everybody was with frostbite and we couldn't be evacuated for a day because ceasefire was not on, firing was going on, and helicopter tried very hard to land, but they could not. It took them a day of persistent effort to try and land, and after that we evacuated from there. It was a difficult decision. But after my injury, I realized I wouldn't have been able to serve in the forward areas and I wouldn't have been able to serve in the capacity that I signed up for. I wanted to be a soldier. I wanted to be physically present and contribute in my own way. Army was really helpful. They said, we'll look after you. You're a battle casualty. You will give you administrative work and do what you want to do. I listened to my heart. I said, I didn't sign up for this. I wanted to be in part of the action and be with the boys and be able to physically contribute towards the cause. Once I realized I wouldn't be able to do that, I said desk job is not that something I signed up for with the army. I decided to hang my uniform, studied for a year and then did my MBA after that.
Colonel Vasanth Venugopal was the commanding officer of 9th Battalion of Maratha Light Infantry. He martyred fighting terrorists crossing the Indian border at Uri. He always cared for his juniors, jawans. Indian army was all up to look after his widowed wife and two daughters. But this great soldier's great wife decided not to just be a veer nari but to carry forward his husband's mission.
He was commanding his battalion and it was in Uri sector and he led from the front. He always believed that he should be in front doing what he asks his men to do, and it was unfortunate that he was martyred. Vasanth was always thinking about his jawans. So for me, it was very natural to think about their wives because I felt that, you know, nobody really understands what the wives go through. And it's always the heroic nature of the martyr that is lauded. But it is the woman behind him who is also very strong and has supported him all through to do what he wants to do. So I've always felt that the women also need a lot of credit. And when things like this happen, they need to be supported because in our society, you know how the label of being a widow can be very heavy. It's got many, many connotations and it's very unfair that a woman should be made to feel a victim when she is not. So we started this foundation in memory of Vasanth to reach out to Jawan's families in particular, because I felt that the young women were dealing with a lot of social pressures. Like I said, the label of a widow can be very heavy on women. Whereas when a man loses his wife, it's quite normal for him to be considered, oh, okay, fine, now what next? But for a woman, it's like the end of her life and she is alive. So it's more on a social construct that I have started dealing with this kind of a program, that we want to help the women come out of their trauma, and we do a lot of emotional counseling. We help them recover. And we, of course, make sure that they know what are all their entitlements, and we connect with all of those things. So basically, the organization is sitting in the middle. We are reaching out to families, we are connecting with the government agencies, and we also help the civilian community to look at these things differently and do their bit also.
Hawaldar Ramesh Pahekar from 22 Maratha was deployed with 27 Rashtri Rifles when in an ambush, he killed 5 terrorists but sustained a gunshot. Despite being injured, he followed other terrorists and killed 2 more. For his valor, this great Maratha soldier was awarded Shaurya Chakra.
27 Rashtriya Rifle mein sevarat ke dauran 5 जून 2001 को जम्मू कश्मीर के पुंछ इलाके में सुरंगकोट तहसील के पीर पंजाल में एक ऑपरेशन में शामिल था। तलाश और विद्वान मिशन का सदस्य होने के नाते मैंने आतंकवादियों के घुसपैठियों और आने जाने रास्ते पर घात लगाया और उसके बाद आंधी और बारिश की 48 घंटे निरंतर चौकसी के बाद मेरे कॉलम ने देखा कि एक नाले के समीप के नाले के साथ साथ एक आतंकवादी दल जा रहा था। उसका मैंने स्वेच्छा से अपने नेतृत्व किया और अकेले 5 आतंकवादियों को मार गिराया। उसके दौरान आतंकवादियों ने मेरे ऊपर बहुत सी गोलीबारी की, उसके बाएं साइड से मेरे को उसके बाद गोली लग गई। गोली लगने के बाद मेरी परवाह न करते हुए मैं गंभीर रूप से घायल होने के बाद भी मैंने उनका पीछा किया और अकेले ही 2 आतंकवादी को मार गिराया। उसके बाद मेरे जो ये थे साथी उनको इससे खतरे से बचाते हुए अपना उनका घेरे में आतंकवादी को घेरे रहा। उसी काम के लिए मेरे को 26 जनवरी 2002 को राष्ट्रपति महोदय द्वारा शौर्य चक्र से सम्मानित किया गया।
हवलदार सुरेंद्र सिंह belongs to 8 Marathas, currently deployed with NSG. He won Sena Medal for operation against Ulfa militants in Assam.
सबसे पहले तो सर मराठा लाइट इन्फेंट्री अपने आप में एक बहुत ही बड़ी रेजिमेंट है और इसमें मेरे को सर्विस करके बहुत ही अच्छा लग रहा था। तो मैं 8वीं बटालियन का नुमाइंदा हूँ। मैं हवलदार जी 8वीं कमीशन लिया था 2000 में और मेरा जो मेरे को राष्ट्रपति द्वारा 2011 में सेना मेडल से नवाजा गया था। मैंने एक ऑपरेशन में हिस्सा लिया था जो अपर असम में किया गया था और इसमें मैंने 2 उल्फा के जो उग्रवादी थे जो उसके एरिया कमांडर थे उनको मार गिराया था। तो इस उपलक्ष्य में मेरे को ये सेना मेडल से नवाजा गया। सर मराठा लाइट की जो ट्रेनिंग है वो बहुत ही अच्छी ट्रेनिंग है और जो बंदा एक बार मराठा सेंटर में जो ट्रेनिंग कर लेता है वो पूरी इंडियन आर्मी में कहीं भी किसी भी कैसे भी हालात हो उसमें आराम से नौकरी कर लेता है। और मेरे को तो सबसे गौरव महसूस हो रहा है कि मैं मराठा रेजिमेंट के अंदर नौकरी कर रहा हूँ सर्विस के अंदर। बाकी 120 कदम चलते हैं, हम 140 कदम चलते हैं तो हमारी जो लाइट इन्फेंट्री की जो उपाधि दी गई है उसी से गौरवान्वित हो जाती है। उससे पता लगता है कि हम लोग कितने फास्ट हैं, इसलिए तो हमारी रेजिमेंट को लाइट की इन्फेंट्री दी गई है, उपाधि दी गई है।
सोल्जर इज ए सोल्जर एंड ही परफॉर्म्स इक्वली वेल इन द फील्ड ऑफ स्पोर्ट्स। सुबेदार राम पवार इज एन एक्लेम्ड इंटरनेशनल रेसलिंग कोच and wrestling judge and referee. He proved that spirit of a soldier and brings joy, pride and achievement to us Indians.
मेन हम छत्रपति शिवाजी महाराज को मानते हैं जिनके नाम से ही हर मराठा यूनिट के जो जवान हैं उनके एक हौसला मिलता है उनके जयकारा से। उस रेजिमेंट का अगर हम हिस्सा है तो ये अपने आप के एक गर्व महसूस करते हैं, चाहे हम मैदान के जंग में हो या हम अगर खेल के मैदान में हो। मैं सर सुबेदार राम पवार इंटरनेशनल रेसलिंग कोच हूँ और इंटरनेशनल रेसलिंग जज एंड रेफरी हूँ। सर मैं एशियन चैम्पियनशिप और वर्ल्ड चैम्पियनशिप में देश के इंडिया टीम का कोच रह चुका हूँ, जिसमें इंडिया ने स्वर्ण पदक, सिल्वर मेडल तथा ब्रॉन्ज मेडल जीते हैं। जो मैं एक एज ए स्पोर्ट्समैन होते हुए मराठों का जो इतिहास है स्पोर्ट्स के इसमें भी वो ओलंपिक से लेके हर स्टेज में देश के लिए नाम रोशन करने का काम किया है और अभी भी हमारे कई रेसलर्स कई स्पोर्ट्समैन इंटरनेशनल लेवल में अचीव कर रहे हैं और इसके आगे भी हम बेहतर प्रदर्शन करते रहेंगे। सर
जी आपने कोई लड़ाई लड़ी, कोई ऑपरेशन को अंजाम दिया या शुरू से ही आप रेसलिंग में रहे?
सर मैं स्पोर्ट्स के लिए स्पोर्ट्स कोटा से भर्ती हो गया था सर, वहीं से मैं स्पोर्ट्स के फील्ड में रहा हूँ। जैसे मैं 2001 में भर्ती हो गया सर, मैं 2007 तक मैंने रेसलिंग की। 2007 में मैंने NIS डिप्लोमा कोर्स किया जहाँ मैं ए ग्रेड और बेस्ट स्टूडेंट रहा हूँ। 2009 में मैं इंटरनेशनल जज एंड रेफरी का कोर्स पास किया जो वर्ल्ड रेसलिंग फेडरेशन लेता है और जो देश का सबसे कम उम्र का रेफरी था उस टाइम जिस टाइम मैंने पास किया है। और अभी फ़िलहाल मैं 2016 में यूनाइटेड वर्ल्ड रेसलिंग का लेवल 1 कोचिंग कोर्स पास किया हूँ जो इंडियन आर्मी में मैं अकेला हूँ।
February 4 इज़ द मराठा लाइट इन्फेंट्री डे। नेशनल डिफेंस विशेज मराठा लाइट इन्फेंट्री एंड इंडियन आर्मी ए वेरी हैप्पी मराठा डे। जय हिंद।